Hey guys, my name is Bo with TechT Paintball, and in this video I'm going to be showing you the new TechT MRT Phenom bolt. Just a couple of its features include a soft bolt tip O-ring to cut down on the ball breakage that these things are known for, as well as it makes the gun a little bit more efficient, quieter, less kick. Typically what I do with these videos is I show you guys our stock operating pressure. With this gun, I can't necessarily do that because the regulator is part of the actual operating system. It's not a standard regulator down here where I could throw a gauge on it and show you the difference. So on this one, I'm going to show you our stock velocity, and we're going to switch over to the new MRT Phenom bolt and show you the raise in velocity. And then instead of showing the pressure drop, we're basically just going to have to show how many turns I can bring the regulator down to get it back down to the same velocity. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot a couple clearing shots, and then we're going to shoot 30 shots through the chronograph to get our stock velocity. So one or two clearing shots. Now let's see what our stock velocity is. All right, so our stock velocity is 281.1. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the tank off. I'm not gonna change the regulator or anything like that. And I'm gonna switch over to the new bolt, to the new MRT Phenom bolt. It's a pretty simple installation. I've actually already made an installation video, so I'm not gonna go too much into the installation on this, although you'll probably be able to just see me do it. So I'm not going to change anything else. As you can see, I'm just going to pull the stock one out. I'm even going to put the same ball back in there. You always got to be sure you put your cycling back on. I can't tell you how many times I've forgotten to do that. All right, so as you guys can see, it's a super easy installation. You don't need to change anything. There's no tools required. I'm a big fan of the Phenom, the whole operating system, everything I'm a big fan of. I think it's really cool. Gonna throw my air on. Now, our last velocity with the stock bolt was 281.1. As you guys saw, I haven't changed anything. I'm gonna shoot one or two clearing shots, and then we're gonna shoot 30 shots to get the new velocity reading, and we'll talk a little bit about what that means. So, one or two clearing shots, see where our velocity is now. All right, so after 30 shots, we have a new velocity of 304.1. So that's roughly 23, 24 feet per second that we added. Most of our testing has gotten us 30 feet per second. Pretty much consistent as gravity, we've always gotten 30 feet per second as a drop-in. So with that one, we really saw about 24, but that could be from the paint, that could be from a large variety of things. But even 24 or 30 feet per second is a huge increase, and that's gonna make a large difference as far as efficiency goes. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and bring my velocity back down. And I'm going to do so by using the regulator just like we should. I'm going to get it right here where you guys can see it real well. I'm going to start off by trying to turn it down 5 turns. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I'm going to shoot a clearing shot again, and then we're going to see what our velocity is at now. So there's one or two clearing shots. Let's see where our velocity is at now. I'm only going to do 10 shots this time. So our new velocity is 283.5. So that's pretty close. Just as a drop-in, like I just showed you guys, we're increasing the velocity regularly by about 30 feet per second. With this test, we got about 24. So still pretty consistent as far as the fact that we are increasing the velocity. Now that means a couple of different things. Just as a drop-in, raising the velocity that high, we didn't change the amount of air being released, we didn't change anything like that, but it increased the velocity by quite a bit. So what that means is by lowering your pressure, you're gonna get better efficiency. By just changing that one item and seeing the velocity go up, that means we can turn the pressure down and we're gonna get more shots per tank. We're also going to have less ball breakage. The Phenoms are kind of notorious for ball breakage. If you look at the stock bolt, if you set a ball on top of it, you can see it doesn't cup the ball very well, and it's just a very hard surface against the ball. Ours has the same bolt tip that we have on our mini bolts, which just cups the ball very well, creates a great seal in the breech, ensures that all that air is forced down the barrel, as well as just gives the ball something gentle to rest on with the bolt. It's also lighter, so it's going to cause a little bit less kick, and it's also quite a bit quieter as well because of the pressure drop. If you have any questions about the MRT Phenom bolt, feel free to visit our website at www.techtpaintball.com, or you can give us a call at 901-405-1848, or you can email me directly at beau@techtpaintball.com. That's beau@techtpaintball.com. Go out and get you guys a Phenom MRT bolt. I promise you will be happy with it. These things are great. Thanks, everybody.